Hello, my Shiver of Sharks. Welcome back to my channel. You can call me Lolly. We are in a bit of a different setup here. Natural light? Who is she? So I'm going to try to do the makeup and book tag. Because if this is not your first video of mine, then you will know that I make videos talking about books and then talking about makeup, mostly eyeshadow. And the reason I say try to, because this is the first time that I'm, like, filming myself putting on makeup, like, in a get ready with me style. But the makeup and book tag has 11 questions that relate to each traditional step of the makeup process that you answer with a book. From what I've seen, the original creator of the tag is unknown. The video has been deleted or made private. But some of the questions were added by SarawithoutanH, so I will tag her video in the description box. I will also list all of the questions in the description box. I'm going to do the questions in the order that I do my makeup, which it may not be the order that you will see if you watch other videos of this tag. So let me grab the few things I'm missing, and then we will get into tag questions. Okay. I'm also, instead of holding up the books that I own, I'm just going to put a picture of the cover here, since I can't really hold them and do makeup at the same time. So, anyway, first question, primer. I'm using the e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer. It's my only primer, so it's got quite a bit of use in it. Anyway. The question is, primer, pick a book that makes a lasting impression. I've got two books I want to answer with this. The first is a book I've recently read called Educated by Tara Westover. I talk about it in my August wrap-up. That is a memoir from a woman who was raised by Mormon survivalists in rural Idaho. She never went to school. She never went to a traditional doctor. She eventually grew curious enough about the world outside of her family's little compound and made her way to Brigham Young University and Oxford and Cambridge. And it made an impression in that it demonstrates very much the power of human curiosity and the ways in which access to an education can be very liberating. And actually, since I also use eye primer, I'm using the NYX HD eye primer. So for my second book, I'm going to pick Buzzed. So this is a book that I remember reading in one of my favorite classes I took in college. It was something like psychosocial pharmaceuticals. It was basically about drugs, about mostly illicit substances, but also like alcohol and tobacco. And basically it was about what was happening in your brain on a neurotransmitter level, what it does to your motor functions, what it does to your ability to socialize, and then also a little bit of the history, a little bit of why they're classified the way they were, where they came from, how they were developed. And this also made an impression because, like, the book is really understanding the difference between stimulants like caffeine and cocaine, and then depressants like alcohol and marijuana, and the ways in which combining them interacts. Like, for example, I know that it's really dangerous to combine ecstasy with marijuana because it basically makes you cold-blooded. It makes your body unable to regulate temperature. So if you're in a very warm place, like a cramped rave, you're gonna overheat. But then if you go outside and it's really cold, you're more likely to get hypothermia because your body just can't regulate, but also because you're intoxicated, you're not really going to clue in to your body being in distress. But then it's also very interesting reading about the history of these drugs. I think it's really informative in terms of, like, how much addiction is not a choice. It's very much happening at the neurotransmitter level, the way that your brain responds to these various chemicals. So yeah, it's something I would like to read again, but it was really cool. And I recommend it. Next, I'm going to do eyeshadow. Pick a book with your favorite colors on the cover. So this is a book I don't own, but I recently read, Gods of Jade and Shadow. Purple, teal, gold. I don't know if I'm gonna use all of those colors, but purple and teal, I'm gonna try and combine them. I'm gonna be using my Menagerie Cosmetics Violet Ink palette. She looks like this. And then I'm gonna be using at least the shimmer from the Melt Cosmetics Muerte palette. This is Angelito. I might use some shades from my newest palette. This is the Colored Rain Vivid Pigments palette. I have a video where I swatch all of these shades on my arm, and then I go through each color and see if I have any dupes in my collection. It was a fun time. Anyway, so I might be dipping into like these blues and purples over here. We'll see. So, Gods of Jade and Shadow. So this is also a book I talked about in my September wrap-up. This is a story that follows a young woman in 1920s Mexico when she accidentally releases an imprisoned Mayan death god. And her body kind of gets tied to him, and she's kind of running out of time to help him achieve his goal in defeating his brother who imprisoned him. She's kind of has to help him, or otherwise she'll die. So this had beautiful world setting, just the description of she starts in a small town in Mexico in the Yucatan and travels up to Mexico City. So you just get these beautiful descriptions of Mexico in the 1920s in these very different regions. You learn a lot about, you know, this, the mythology around these Mayan gods. The main character, Cassiopeia, is interesting. In my review, I talk about how I love the way that she exemplifies a lot of the themes of the changing era that is the 1920s. So yeah, it was a fun time. Ooh, I got a lot of that on my lid. I did not mean to. I have very deep set eyes, so getting really into my crease is interesting. So far, if you're curious, I've dipped into Iron Grip here for kind of transition all over my crease, and now I'm dipping into Octopi, this kind of bluish purple, to deepen up the crease area. Now I'm gonna put some NYX Glitter Glue Primer on my lid. I'm not necessarily using a glitter, but again, because my eyes are so deep set, shimmers need just a little extra help not getting completely eaten up by my crease. Tell. Ooh, all Also, I realize I never showed you the lid, the cover for this eyeshadow palette, but since we're talking about like Mexican death gods, how could I not? Next, I'm gonna do concealer. Okay, so concealer. Pick a character you wish you could get rid of. So I've got two answers for this. First off is the character of Mogget in Golden Hand by Garth Nix. Now this may seem odd because Mogget is one of my favorite characters from this series. But, and I will talk more about this with another question where I talk about this book, but his appearance in that book is basically only there because we know he's a fan favorite and because the author wrote himself into a corner and he needed a powerful magical creature to save the day. It was nice to return to the world, but it was clear that the author either was rushed to finish it or didn't really care about fleshing out the story and making it into something interesting. Similarly, my other thought for this was the character of Enlil in The Warrior Queen, which is book 4 of the 100th Queen series by Emily R. King. So he is a god character who we may have talked about, but we haven't seen before. And he appears and he becomes like this random extra love interest for the main character and creates this potential sort of love triangle, but I wish he wasn't there because, like, I knew from the beginning that it wasn't going to be a contest. Our main character, Kalinda, she was either going to succeed in rescuing Devon or she was going to die trying. And, like, no amount of remembering what her past self was and who that past self was to the character of Enlil, like, it was, I feel like, their past selves appearing to be a point of tension and like character development between them, cool, but like very much focusing on this potential upset romance, I wasn't here for it. Sorry, Emily. I'm gonna finish up my lower lash line. I'm going to do eyeliner. What's the question? Pick a dark and mysterious book. So this is, I'm gonna pick Sawkill Girls by Claire Legrand. I am currently in the middle of this. I am listening to it on audiobook and the audiobook narration is so fucking good. I think this book was kind of on my radar of something to read, but I ultimately went with the audiobook, I think, after hearing Noelle talk about it. I don't remember exactly what Noelle's channel is called, but I will definitely link it in the description box. I got this recommendation off of her video of, like, some of her favorite audiobooks of all time. And yes, the narrator is so, so good. So, Sawkill Girls is about a small coastal town named Sawkill, where young girls, keep disappearing. And before it was like, you know, every 40 years, every 50 years, but like, you know, then a girl goes missing only like 8 months after the other one. They go missing because there is this dark power housed on the island that is served by the family of one of the girls' perspectives that we follow. And he needs these girls to come into power and be free and be able to move around and roam the world on his own. So I'm only halfway through it. But yeah, the narration is so good. Anyway, slightly paranormal, very atmospheric, very creepy. I'm loving it so far. Okay, now I'm going to do my top eyeliner, and I'm definitely not going to be able to talk while I do that. And for this, my waterline, I used this LA Girl Glide Gel Liner. It's not super long lasting, but it doesn't irritate my eyes, which, cool. And then my liquid liner is a Stila All Day Waterproof Liquid Liner. Okay, considering how weird an angle I'm sitting at, I feel like my wings came out pretty even. What next? I'm gonna do brows next. So I am using an e.l.f. little potted cream liner in their brown shade, and then this kind of stiff angled brush. And what I do is I kind of tap into the color, and then I kind of work it on the back of my hand so it's not like a harsh dark line. Okay, what's the question for eyebrows? Pick a book you think everybody should read. So another book I talk about in my September wrap-up is The Undocumented Americans. Now the thing with this book is, as much as I want this book to be super successful and have a lot of people read it, I recognize that there's a lot of people in this country who aren't ready to read it. But I can still want it. I can dream big. Why not? Why not? So this is a book written by Carla Cornejo Villavicencio. She writes about, this is part exploratory journalism and part memoir, talking about the undocumented Latinx immigrant experience in America after they come here. I've seen a lot of people comment on how she never asks anyone that she's talking to or talks about or brings up their journey to get here. Because, like, there's enough of that. So it's a collection of essays that explore the different communities of undocumented people living here. And it's just telling their stories. It's a fabulous bit of writing. I will link again the interview with the author that was on the Stacks podcast. I will also link the discussion with, what is her channel name? I know her name is Lupita, but she and the host of the Stacks pod did like a book club discussion about the book. That's not very spoilery, but it is also interesting to kind of unpack the book a little bit more. Anyway, it's really fascinating. It's really good. It's a really, really excellent collection of essays. The writing is fantastic. Yeah, and I very much look forward to reading the future works that this author comes out with. All right, what next? I think it's time to move out on to foundation. Now this is going to be a little bit of a work of an effort. So I don't own too many foundations, but like my perfect like winter shade is the Make Up Forever Water Blend in Y225. But I still have a little bit of summer color. Somehow I managed to get summer color with how much I'm being inside. So I'm gonna mix in a little bit of this Vitalist Healthy Elixir in 705. Okay, and then this is a technique that I learned from Audra at home. What I do is I get like a little bit of foundation onto my brush, and then I kind of work it into the bristles in the back of my hand, and then apply it to my face. I like a very sheer coverage, and like this kind of working it into the bristles, it really helps just their it helps for there to like not be any streaks, and it just gives a really, really smooth, buffed in appearance. Okay, what is the question that I'm supposed to be talking about? Pick your favorite first book in a series. yet another book I talk about in that wrap up. I'll talk about two, so we have a little bit of variety. So my first thought was Sabriel by Garth Nix. This is just a great introduction to this world. I gush about it in that other video. I think it and the second book, Lyrael, are probably both equally good, but I think Lyrael, is only so good because of the world building already established by Sabriel. So the other book I'm thinking of is The Amulet of Samarkand by, what's his name? Jonathan Stroud. So I love all the books in this series. This is, oh my god, this is such a fun fantasy book. So this series follows a genie named Bartimaeus. In this world, all magicians get their power by summoning and binding various magical entities from their other plane. So you've got like little imps, you've got kind of like medium, higher power genie, and then you've got like these greater powers. So Bartimaeus is not the most powerful, but he's very clever and very witty, and I mean, he's got like quite a bit of power, but mostly he's very clever. And this book, it's just a joy to see how he problem solves the various situations that he's in. Because with the magical bindings, he will be instructed to like break into so-and-so's house and like steal their shit. And he's like, cool, there's all of these like safeguards. I am bound to do this or I'm going to be tortured. So even when he's going up against powers that are, you know, greater than him in the hierarchy, how does he manage to outwit them? There's a lot of like footnotes in the writing, which I think it's a really clever way to add a little bit of world building, because Bartimaeus will, you know, elaborate, but also because the magical beings can see in more than like three dimensions. Humans can only kind of see in a couple of dimensions, but they can see in more planes of existence. I think I don't know if this was intentional, but it's kind of an interesting way to add another dimension to writing. So you're not just reading the story linearly, but once in a while you kind of break out and here's this other bit of the story that kind of like sits on top of or adjacent to the thing that you're currently reading. I don't know if it's intentional, but it fits and I like it. That whole series is great, but man, that book was such a fun time. Okay, so there's not a question for bronzers, so I'm just gonna do this real quick. I'm using the Milani Silky Matte Bronzer in 02. I think this is a little bit too light for me, but I'll just kind of go on kind of heavy with it. Now it's time for blush. So I'm gonna use this little Cover FX blush in Spiced Cinnamon. So this question is, pick a book with a cringe-worthy romance. I'm going to have to go with Golden Hand again. Both of the romances. Both the romance with Lyrael and Nicholas, and then the kind of like shoved-in romance at the end with Samith, and I forget the name of the other girl. She was interesting all by herself. She didn't need a romance. Yes, a young woman having desires and taking it and not being ashamed of it, but like, it's not good. It didn't fit. That might have been too dark. I know that like romance in YA is a really common trope, but like, I'm really tired of romances that blossom during a really catastrophic event. Like, here you are, the weight of the world literally on your shoulders, dependent on whether or not, like, you have to save the world, but you also, like, can't stop thinking about this romance. Like, no, like, you've got enough shit to worry about. And also, like, the thing with Lyrel and Nicholas, like, she's grown up, like, pretty much only around a lot of women, so, like, a lot of her attraction to Nicholas is, like, he's the first young man she knows that she's not related to. And it just feels really weird how intense their attraction is and how much of a focal point it is in the book. I didn't like it. Nope. Now I'm gonna do highlighter. I did not forget about mascara, don't worry. So for highlighter, I'm gonna use this Depotted Physician's Formula Shimmer Brick. You know what? I'm also gonna put some of this gold shimmer right in my inner corner because I think that's gonna go with the Gauze and Jade and Shadow cover really well. Highlighter. Pick a book that brightened your day. Man, another book that I talk about in my last wrap up. I promise I have a longer memory than just the books I read last month, but a lot of them just fit this description really well. So that's gonna be Get a Life, Chloe Brown. I mentioned in that other video that it's the first romance that I've ever read, like true adult romance, and it was delightful and it brightened my day, and it's was such a beautiful relationship to follow, and these are like wonderfully dimensional, flawed, but able to grow people. Did I put on too much? Never. So yes, it's fantastic. I am so looking forward to reading the other books by this author and to dipping my toes into reading more romance. Now I really look like a peacock. So mascara is pick a long book. So I'm not gonna pick one that has like a lot of pages, but I'm gonna pick one that, I'm gonna pick The Historian by Elizabeth Kostova. I don't remember which video I talk about it. It might have been like my first monthly wrap up. The story is very slow. It's got a little bit of action in there. It follows like vampire folklore. It's basically a couple of historians and this is difficult, and an archaeologist following the trail of Dracula and finding evidence of him in historical texts. You know, I describe it as like, this is not Indiana Jones looking for Dracula, it's academics looking for Dracula. But it's still very interesting. It's got beautiful world building. It describes these beautiful Eastern European towns, these beautiful European cities. The story spans three different perspectives telling. So it starts with this first modern historian, and then his protege picking up the trail, and then the protege's daughter. So the story of this investigation spans a long time. The story is very, it's slow, but it's like, it's very thorough. It's very lush. You know, this is a great, like, curl up with some tea or cocoa on a rainy day and just settle in to, like, meander through this world. I mean, it does have, like, a lot of pages. I'll put over here if I can find what the page count is. So it's not a short book, but like, it's not like a huge tome, but it's not like a fast-paced action story. So it's a story that you very much take your time with. Powder. I'm not someone who uses a lot of powder. This is like my Rimmel Stay Matte that I finally did hit pan on. But you can see how much of the imprint is still there and the rest of it. I've had this for like 2 years. I don't use a lot of powder. What's a question for powder? Pick your favorite last book in a series. So this is going to be Shatterglass by Tamora Pierce. I love Tamora Pierce's work. I own pretty much all of her books except for one short story collection and like one graphic novel that she worked on. But this book, this is not her Tortall world. It's her other world that deals with elemental magic. And this is the fourth of the second series. This follows Trisana, who is a weather and earth mage. And one of the things that's established in this world is all the mages have like their mage kit. They have the various tools that help them and use their power out in the world. And her mage kit is her hair. She's got this curly, unruly, thick red hair, and to keep it out of the way, she does it up in all of these little braids and twists and buns, and she uses the braids and the knots and things to weave different powers in there. So like she'll have a little bit of lightning woven into some strands here. She'll have like the power of an earthquake and a thick braid along the top of her head so that she doesn't have to draw upon raw elements by herself. She can kind of store them the way that like a medic would store medicine in different vials. So part of what I love is she's my favorite character of that world. I like that she's like a little bit curmudgeon-y and grumpy, but also like very intelligent and like very much like not afraid to set boundaries. She like even as like a child, she's very much like demands that adults treat her with respect. And it's great. But also this is like an interesting like time sensitive murder mystery, because she encounters a man who is a glassblower who has recently been struck by lightning, and it has imbued him with like some lightning power that's wreaking havoc on his ability to control his glassblowing. But he ends up blowing these glass orbs that have, how do I not spoil this? These glass orbs that have lightning in them, that when the lightning clears, it shows something relevant to criminal activity that's happening in the city. So it's a little bit like detective mystery, plus magic, plus these interesting characters. Yeah, it's great. I love it. Okay, last question. Lipstick. Pick your favorite book kiss. Like I mentioned, I haven't read a lot of romance. Not a fan of a lot of romance in YA. For lips, I am going to use this Bite Beauty lip pencil in Glacé. Cool. So for this answer, I picked The Night Circus by Erin Morgenstern. I love the romance in this. I love that while it was super relevant to the story and like a point of tension in the story, it didn't overwhelm the plot. So no, I don't have super strong feelings about being like the most perfect kiss in literature, just because I don't have a lot to compare it to that really stands out. But I felt really invested in the relationship, and I felt like the build-up was satisfied, and then like the first kiss was like a great moment, and then like other key points in the relationship, like it was like the pacing of the relationship within the whole story was good. So that's the book tag, that's the look. I actually really like how the eyes turned out. It's kind of a gray, it's definitely, the weather's definitely turned, it's definitely fall, but and this is definitely brightened up. I like this. I like this talking and doing makeup. I need to do more of this. Have a great rest of your day. I encourage you to go out into the world and be curious. Please vote. Please have a plan for how to make sure your vote is safe and sent in on time. I'll have a couple of other resources in the description box, including a link to learn more about the Black Lives Matter movement, a link to bail funds. I'll catch you folks in my next video. Bye! We'll be right back.